How did galaxies like the Milky Way come to be? How do stars and planets form? And are there planets nearby that could host life? These are some of the questions that ESO's extremely large telescope, the ELT, seeks to answer. Set to start operating later this decade, the ELT will host a suite of high-tech instruments capable of matching its immense light-collecting abilities. Unique among them is METIS, the multi-tool instrument of the Extremely Large Telescope. METIS, or the Mid-Infrared ELT Imager and Spectrograph, will be operating in the mid-infrared. Infrared light can pierce through clouds of dust and gas to reveal what would otherwise be obscured. This allows us to witness the birth of stars and planets, and peer into the center of galaxies to study their enigmatic black holes. METIS will specifically be looking at mid-infrared light. Hot objects fade away, and cooler objects like asteroids and exoplanets can be seen more clearly. This enables METIS to observe the atmospheres of those planets in more detail than ever before, in the hopes of finding habitable worlds. METIS is constructed with a 3-in-1 solution. First, it has its own adaptive optics sensor system, which works in tandem with the ELT's mirrors. It can measure turbulence in the Earth's atmosphere and correct for its blurring effects in real time. Then, the light is guided either to a high contrast camera that will create sharper infrared images than ever before, or it is directed to the METIS spectrograph, which separates the light into its constituent colors. It will provide very high resolution and unsurpassed sensitivity and allow scientists to learn the chemical composition and motion of astronomical objects. METIS is realized by a large international consortium in collaboration with ESO.
NOVA is the PI Institute leading the whole METIS instrument. NOVA is delivering a major piece of hardware, the Common 4 optics, which is essentially the first set of optics and filters in the cryogenic instrument. We deliver that to Leiden University, where our other 11 different partners are delivering their pieces, and we will assemble the whole METIS instrument.
There are numerous aspects why I really enjoy the work for METIS. One is working with the consortium. We have 10 partners from Europe, we have one from Taiwan, one from the US. Meeting all those different people, the different cultures, is a very inspiring experience. Then, of course, there is the technical aspects. We're really developing solutions to do something that no one has done before, using the biggest telescope on the Earth to do something. So that's certainly an inspiration.
The Max Planck Institute for Astronomy is responsible for the imager and the adaptive optics subsystem. So for me, the most exciting aspect is the scientific challenges which METIS will solve.
For such an instrument, you need, of course, mechanics, you need optics, you need control electronics, you need a lot of programming, you need software. For a project of this size, which we have never done before, invest a lot of time in budgeting, in risk management, control of the quality to make the instrument a success.
METIS will weigh in at 18 tons, roughly the same as three well-padded elephants. Guiding the light through it requires a complex system with 243 optical surfaces, including over 55 precision polished mirrors. In the end, the light will have traveled 36 meters within the instrument. All of METIS Science modules are encased in a vacuum chamber that can cool them down. This is essential so that the infrared light emitted by the instrument itself does not contaminate the signal.
So cryogenic instrumentation is generally very difficult because we are cooling down optics and mechanics down to temperatures to 40 Kelvin, or this is minus 230 degrees Celsius. So this is very cold, it's not accessible. In addition, when you build mechanical parts that move around, they tend to not apply the same functions at cold. So you need to engineer them very carefully in order to have a robust instrument. And finally, it's also the whole thermal design. Cooling down things to that temperature requires a very thorough thermal engineering, and this is what we have to do with METIS.
METIS has many areas where it will do superior work, but there are two that are extremely important and unique for METIS, and that is protoplanetary disks and exoplanets.
METIS will be a frontrunner in exoplanet research, with a particular strength in taking direct images of them. It will be equipped with a set of highly specialized coronagraphs that can shield the bright light of a star to reveal its fainter and cooler planets. With this technique, METIS could ignore the beacon of a lighthouse and identify a firefly next to it.
Two main things where the ELT will be completely game-changing. So one of them will be the characterization of the planets that are already known. So we will be able to provide much deeper insight into the atmosphere of these planets, which will tell us how they formed and how they evolved, what they are made of, possibly even find some possible signs of things that might relate to life. The second goal of METIS will be to find smaller planets down to rocky planets, terrestrial planets, where life could possibly form.
So the main science goal for exoplanets with METIS will be to contribute addressing the key question of the formation of planetary systems. We will also be able to observe planets that are further away from their parent stars and obtain spectra for this planet that we cannot have today.
Because of the light-collecting capabilities of the ELT, the METIS spectrograph will be able to detect elements and molecules in the atmospheres of exoplanets. It can do this within just a few hours of exposure and therefore observe planets at a much higher pace. But crucially, since METIS operates in mid-infrared, it is dedicated to observing cooler exoplanets with temperatures approaching Earth's. This will make it a game changer in the search for habitable worlds. The ELT and JWST will complement each other in the mid-infrared wavelength. JWST is able to detect fainter objects and covers a much larger field of view, whereas the ELT will provide sharper images and a higher spectral resolution.
We will be able, with a METIS instrument, to probe planets that are not accessible by the James Webb Space Telescope. So having both those two instruments allows us to better understand this exoplanetary system.
The quality of the collaboration in the METIS consortium is higher than most projects I've been on in the past. And I think this leads to our success. It'll be extremely fulfilling to see all the different pieces come together. The biggest thing is feeling the joy for the team.
It's a long way. It's something like 15 years from the start of the project till we finally will have it on the mountain. And this is a moment I really look forward to.
I certainly dream of standing on this platform and seeing the telescope and the instruments working together. I think that must be extraordinary just because of the size.
I'd be very excited if the next generation of astronomers use the instrument and write great science papers of things that could not have been possible otherwise. If they are excited about the instrument, use it and find something that no other instrument, no other telescope could have found.
The ELT's multi-tool instrument METIS will become an invaluable asset to help us understand the cosmos. It will let us peer into the birth chambers of planets and stars. It will study the evolution of galaxies, the atmospheres of exoplanets, and make us rethink our place in the universe.